Which board is faster, the Raspberry Pi Pico or an ESP32 based board? To find out, we will do two simple tests. First, we run the Pico at its normal 133 MHz speed against the ESP32 at 240 MHz. Then we crank the Pico up to 240 MHz so both boards run at the same clock. Using the same Arduino C++ code to calculate Pi, we will time its run and measure power draw. Which board wins? And is overclocking the Pico worth it? Let's find out. Before we run the computation speed benchmark I have set up, let's quickly review the basic specs so you know what to expect. The Raspberry Pi Pico offers two 32-bit ARM Cortex M0 Plus cores clocked at 133 MHz, which we will overclock later, and comes with 264 kilobytes of SRAM and 2 MB of flash memory. The ESP32, by contrast, uses two 32-bit 10-silica LX6 cores at 240 MHz and packs 520 kilobytes of SRAM plus 4 MB of flash. Based on the clock speeds, the ESP32 should be around 80% faster than the Raspberry Pi Pico. But clock speed isn't everything. The two boards use different types of processor, so performance can vary depending on how each one handles the code. That's why we need to run the same test on both boards to see how much faster the ESP32 really is. Each board will run the same Arduino sketch to calculate the value of Pi using 100,000 iterations of a Pi approximation algorithm running on a single core to keep the code simple and reflect real-world usage, since in practice, most makers don't take advantage of multi-core programming. The result will be then displayed on a 1.8-inch color TFT screen. To make it fair, I'm going to power both boards at the same time using the same power bank. The boot-up time is almost the same for both boards. The Pico is slightly faster at booting up, but that speed difference is not included in the benchmark. Only the time it takes to do the Pi calculation is measured. As you can see, the ESP32 completed the task in about 4.7 seconds, while the Raspberry Pi Pico needed 5.6 seconds. So in this test, the ESP32 is around 19% faster than the Pico. That's a clear difference. But it is smaller than I expected. The Pico runs at 133 MHz, while the ESP32 runs at 240 MHz. That's a much bigger difference in clock speed than in actual performance. You will think that the ESP32 will be almost twice as fast, but in our test, it was only about 19% faster. This shows that clock speed isn't everything. The two boards use different types of processors, and the Pico's Cortex M0 Plus core handles this kind of calculation very efficiently. To see what happens when both boards run at the same clock speed, I overclock the Pico to 240 MHz and run the test again. The results were surprising. The Raspberry Pi Pico completed the task in 3.9 seconds, while the ESP32 needed 4.6 seconds. This means the Pico was about 15% faster, even though both boards were running at the same clock speed. This shows how efficient the Pico's Cortex M0 Plus core is. I also tried pushing the Pico beyond 240 MHz to see if I could squeeze out even more performance. While it supports higher overclocking, I started running into issues. So, for reliable performance, 240 MHz seems to be the safe and stable limit, at least with my setup and the code used in this test. Let's now take a look at power consumption. At 133 MHz, the Raspberry Pi Pico and the display draw around 52 milliamps, and when overclocked to 240 MHz, they draw around 66 milliamps. At the lower end, running the Pico at 50 MHz brings the current down to 41 milliamps. In comparison, the ESP32, together with the same display, draws about 100 milliamps at 240 MHz. All measurements were taken at 5 volts during the benchmark. When we calculate the total energy use, excluding the 20 milliamps used by the display, some interesting patterns appear. The overclocked Pico is faster than the ESP32 in this test, while also using about half the energy. On the other hand, running the Pico at 50 MHz lowers current, but the much longer runtime actually makes it less efficient than at 133 or 240 MHz. In fact, 133 MHz seems to hit the sweet spot, offering the best balance between speed and power consumption. So in this simple benchmark, the results are clear. The Raspberry Pi Pico, even when overclocked, it is not just faster than the ESP32, it is also significantly more energy efficient. Of course, the ESP32 brings other strengths to the table, like built-in Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, features the Pico lacks. But if your project doesn't need those and you are focused on performance and low power, the overclocked Pico is a very strong and underrated option. So there you have it. What do you think about these results? Let me know in the comments. And if you found this comparison helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and stay tuned for more deep dives into embedded hardware.